Alright, you guys, welcome back to the factory. Today we're going to try to set up this encased beam assembly line. Oh, I'm going to peek at what it looks like. Let's see if I can get it to work this time. Bam, there you go. That's what we're going to be setting up. We already got the miners, so we don't have to set these up. The boundary, we'll have to start from here, and then we'll have to run our concrete over from the limestone. Actually, you know what? I think there's limestone right over here somewhere. Which way is... Yeah, this way, this corner. Yeah, there's some right there. So we'll just tap into that. There's some more right there. Alright, we'll just tap into that and pipe it up and over. So, we got quite a bit of room right here to work with. How much further over I'm going to go. We'll see what happens, I guess. Actually, would it be better to build it inside or up here? Assembler. We took a founder and two constructors and a assembler. So we need a coal, which is right here, and iron ore, which is right there. Iron ore. Let's see what it looks like on the inside here. And we need lime too, so don't forget about that. See, it's right up there. I could pipe it straight down through the floor. Okay. I think that's where we're going to go with it. Through the floor and then straight in here. Let's make sure we got everything we need. Go to productions. We're going to need a foundry. Two constructors and a assembler. Foundry on there, we got two constructors. Let's see what it says. The whiteboard is messing it up. Okay. Now. Okay, we got the foundry check. Two of these. One of these. Motors and module frames. And we have that. See, this is reinforced plates. Eventually, I'm going to hook all these up to kind of did like I did right there, a little storage section. It'll probably be twice that big though. Same thing I did downstairs. One downstairs is full. Right, we need 14 rotors. Which is that? Modular frames. Nope. Smart plating next. We need 10 of those. Let's take a second. No, not all of them. Okay. 50 should do it. Have a peek over here. What does the walls look like? Is the hole like in the center of them, or is it offset a little bit? Closer to the bottom. Alright. 1, 2, 3. Third one up. Oh. Hello. Where the hell? I didn't build the steps, did I? Slackers, slackers are slacking. I think right here. This is what we will put. Doesn't matter really. We'll put two. I might want to run something else in there. Might want to run this down from in there or something. We'll do two. If I don't use them both, we don't use them both. Have just in the right spot to pick those damn things. Let's see, let's start from that end and work this way because we got two that's coming in over there and we only got one coming in here. We will put it. Here to go all the way on the side. See, the widest thing is going to be the two constructors side by side. One constructor takes one tile. We got to make sure we leave at least two. We do it right here, just follow this center line down. It should be good. So we need a foundry. Come in from the back. Yeah, that's plenty of room. Actually, that's too much room. Grab that one. That'll work. Alright, we got that. We need vectors. Did the assembler. Make sure we get it far enough apart so the conveyor belts will actually bend like they're supposed to. That'll go there, that'll go there. Let's go from here to there. Concrete, okay. It's going to be making concrete. Okay. Why is that code going so slow? Oh, I didn't ever finish upsetting the conveyor belt up. We gotta go do that. Now that we have enough plates, I said let's sit here and let the game run for like an hour and a half or so. Can't fly through her. Let's see where we leave off at. It's all good there. There. Now she's flowing. I'd like to see. Pure Nova. The MK3 conveyor belt. So MK3 holds 270 resources. That 1.8 was more than enough. Actually, if I do one more power shard, yeah, let's go ahead and do one more. Let's go move it up to 240 per minute. We're worth what, 280? I thought it was 270. 240, 270. But there's basically as much as MK3 hand conveyor belt will handle. The funny enough, there's another cold lobe over there. I think there's three more, actually. I think they're just normal, though. I don't think they're pure. Do I have an offset? No, it's just there. Knock a hole in the wall for a second or two here. Okay, MP3 elevator. Oh. There's the miner. We want two. Okay, that'll work for that. Anything over here? That'll face that way. What are you getting the lights over here doing? Where the hell's that thing? Where's the wire at? There it is. What the F? Okay. Now, go from here to here. And from here to there. And it gives us light. Gotta fix these. They're killing me. this one's gonna be making steel beams, not pipes, beams. Beams. It's gonna be making our enclosed industrial beam. This one be steel. This one should be set up for concrete. Yep. The outlet. These. There. We'll actually need to take that one. Yeah. Do that. Okay. Right there. Right here. Here to this one, this one, over here. Alright, I'll wait to see if it's gonna work. We got the concrete. We forgot the concrete. Now we need a miner. Production advance. No, I can't. We're missing encased beams. Go figure. Oh, I'm still missing a miner. Back over there we go. Okay, now the miner. I think that'll work. Let me do an elevator going down. All right. And try option B. Not option B. Still think it's gonna work. Do this to make it work. What if we took the miner the other direction? That. Let me take the elevator thing. Fucking mouse. Look at that. Oh. see, six concrete, three beams. It'll take twice as many concrete, some concrete will have to be going twice as fast as still beams. And it basically is, more or less, yeah. Still, I just ain't get enough. Ain't get enough concrete. MK3 belt could hold 270. Just takes 270 resources per minute. Been putting out 22.5. The steel beams are stacking up. Or are they going down? One. Need two. We can drink one a little bit of pasty. Let's do another one. We're gonna run out of power here way too much on it. Per minute. Verse 36. I think it's yeah, it's getting pretty steady. Yeah, in case beams, we can upgrade the miners. That's 60 per minute right now. I just want to see something real fast. Let's go back to this. Got to three options. That's pretty much all on the ground. What we're doing is just kind of cover up the gaps. Looks better. I can't believe my storage got full that fast. I mean, it is full. There's what, 2, 4, 6 containers, 6 or 8. Slices, 24 and doubles. There's 2 foot buffer, that's what everybody needs. Okay, I think we should do one over here by this wall. It'll be okay. A row of storage. He loves to do that, tell you that something's lined up when it's not. Okay, so this is going to be our input here, what everything is going to be connected to. Better if we did one more. Let's do one more. It's 2, 4, 6 of them. That should be enough. For a while anyway, we hope. Alright. Eventually, he's gonna have to come back to this. At least on this half of the building. So. One, two, three tiles. If I build another row of machines, I'll probably just put them down in the center. We can come over here. We can bear belt straight down through here. Yeah, that'll work. Let's see, there's that there, so it's gonna have to curve a little bit. I should line it up with the elevator again. This little section is going to have to be running other way. What the hell? How'd I get over here? Okay. Move it over. Metal beans. Okay, as I was saying, this one. He ran the other way. And there we go. Yeah, because it makes it easier. I don't have to run to every individual machine. I can just run over to the string of boxes, go down the line. This over here, I don't know what we're going to do with all this shit. It eventually, I don't know. Who knows? Stations. Trying to paint the door, but you can't paint just the door. Okay. And we let the encased beam stack up. And we can unlock our next milestone, which is expanded power in pro structure. see. How far is there? Here we go. New factory, still ain't got all the bugs kicked out yet. Yeah, this one should be flying all the way down there to the very last one. And then I'll fill up this one, then that one, then that one. Oh, yeah. Actually, I think these we might have enough to unlock the milestone. Minus the frames, I don't think I have 200 frames on me. What did I just click on? Well, some steel plates, come on now. Oh, my inventory is full. I've had to put so many freaking reinforced plates. Maybe it's because I left it running. Oh, I've got the frames. Okay, I'm just going to throw these reinforced plates in here for now. We'll keep, bonus. Let's go through and clean up my inventory. Where are these frames? And we need 200, we've got 40 in there.
Milestone reached. After several pioneers started exhibiting traumatic responses to power blackouts, Fixit developed mitigation tools recommended by your local therapist. Power storages can hold excess power to delay or prevent blackouts in the eventuality that your factory's power consumption exceeds production. To simplify, these are rechargeable batteries. Power towers carry power lines for significantly greater distances than poles, facilitating factory expansion and exploitation of this environment for the good of Fixit and humanity.
Alright, case beams are being made. Turn pipe. can get up here. We got enough of that, I'm sure of. Rashidi will be downstairs. 300. Missing iron plates, huh? Perhaps got the copper sheetings. Right, did we still have them? Can you grab more copper sheeting? 2, 4. That's bars. Copper sheetings, almost enough. Only 300. Run at 28%, how sad. Them backing up, that means they're running fast enough. Probably don't even need that big trees. Output is 30. Input is 40. Best I can get it with the time being. Let's go see if we're getting 15 case pipe. Pretty sure we probably do. No, this post already got is 57 yards. That'll work. Looks like our limestone is slowing us down. For some reason. I gotta quit overclocking things. We're gonna run out of power. Oh, wait, no, it's copper sheet. Well, sheet. I think I won't find you in here. I just set that machine up too. Yeah. How are you here? Checking. Most. Got some coupons. Can't buy a copper sheet. Oh yeah, you can too, right there. How many times did I skip over that? Are you gonna say nothing this time? Got to work on the hub.
By adding hypertube entrances at both ends of hypertubes, pioneers can achieve two-way travel between locations. They are also, error percent safer than jump pads. You dreamed of moving across factories like valued resources, such as rocks and water, and Fixit listened to your dreams. We watched them. We took extensive notes. Hypertubes. Because Fixit makes pioneers' closely monitored dreams come true.
Yeah, hypertubes. That is it. Blueprints is next. We're gonna start working on the space elevator now. You gotta set up the virtual frames. and the smart wiring. There's two more assembly lines. There's a kind of complex too. So I'll have to plan those out and figure out what we're going to. We might put one up here and one downstairs, I don't know. Anyway, yep, we're going to end it here. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to
like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment down below. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.